I see project owners make quite a few mistakes in design and construction projects, but a few come to mind. One is failure to consider the range of options available to the owner for project delivery methods. There's a lot of different ways for the parties involved in construction projects to structure their relationships. In other words, who's going to contract with who? And owners will frequently not give thoughtful consideration to the question of whether or not they should hire the architect or whether they should allow the contractor to hire the architect. And that kind of a decision can have a critical impact on the likelihood that the owner is going to have a good outcome to their project. I also see that owners typically fail to take the time that they need and fail to get the counsel that they need in order to put in place a suite of good design and construction contracts, which is a big mistake because courts typically will not save an owner from the consequences of its own bad business deal. I also find that owners, particularly infrequent builders or occasional consumers of design and construction services, go into projects with unrealistic expectations, but also a lack of awareness about the risks that they face. And if you can't spot the risks, you can't put in place measures to mitigate those risks. Owners should also understand that Illinois law imposes upon them a requirement to collect certain paperwork from contractors before they make payments to the contractors. And if they fail to collect that paperwork, the owners may be forced to pay for the same construction work twice. Owners often also fail to consult their insurance brokers when they're embarking on construction projects, which is something that I would advise every owner to do before a shovel goes into the ground. And lastly, I think that owners fail to give thoughtful consideration to what dispute resolution terms they want to include in their contract. Almost nobody wants to think about a dispute at the early part of the project when everybody's happy and things are going along well. But if you don't take the time to consider whether you're better to have an arbitration clause or a litigation clause as your means of binding dispute resolution, and whether you're going to include a mediation clause or any other terms that may tend to promote early, cost-efficient dispute resolution, the owner may miss an opportunity to have their expectations met.